Boys and girls, welcome to our Wednesday night online experience. We are so excited that you have joined us tonight. We've got some great things planned for you. We're going to be learning about kindness. We are about to enter into a time of worship, but before we do, I want to say a prayer over your house. Lord, thank you so much for these boys and girls. Thank you that they are joining together with us to worship you with their families. We pray for their health. We pray for their safety. Be with us tonight, Lord, as we get to worship and praise your name. Amen.
Through. He helped a boy bring a giant right down. Joshua. changed, I'm forgiven and new. If people need proof, may they see it in me.
Let's look the world in the eye.
Let's look them in the eye and say, my God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do.
I'm not afraid because God
is so big and so strong and so mighty.
Song we could ever sing, worthy of all the praise we could ever bring, worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you, oh, we live for you. Jesus, the name above every other name. Jesus, the only one who could ever say, worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you, we live for you. Holy, there is no one like you. There is none beside you. Open up my eyes in one. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. Oh, we live for you. Holy, there is no one like you. There is none beside you. Open up my eyes in wonder and show.
I'm not afraid.
Hey, boys and girls. I have brought a great friend of mine to help us with our Bible verse today, Chris Cross Crow. You ready to meet him? Hey, Chris Cross.
Hello, it's a beautiful day in the neighborhood. A beautiful day in the neighborhood. Please won't you be my neighbor?
It is a beautiful day, Chris Cross. This weather has been great.
It's so nice outside. Lovely day.
Lovely. All right, Chris Cross, are you ready to help us with our Bible verse?
Oh, yes, I would love to help the boys and girls learn the Bible verse.
All right.
What is it?
Luke 6:31. Do to others.
Okay.
As you would have them do to you.
Luke 6:31. Do to others as you would have them do to you.
That is right. Do you know what that means, Chris Cross?
Well, it means, hold on. It means to do things to others. Or, I don't know, actually. Could you help me with this?
I will. An example of being kind would be to give your brother a hug.
Or you could give your brother a shove.
Huh?
No, Chris Cross, that is not kind.
Oh, okay, I get it.
Hugs, not shoves.
Hugs, not shoves.
Another example is you could help your parents around the house.
Or you could scare your mommy with a mouse.
Oh, my word, Chris Cross. Please do not scare your mom with a mouse. She would scream and cry, or at least I know I would.
Okay, good idea.
So remember, help around the house. Don't scare with a mouse. Okay. Another example, Chris Cross, this would be great for you, is when you are flying high above, you can smile, say hi, and wave.
Or when I'm flying high above, I can drop a little present, a little poopy on their head.
What?
Oh, my word, Chris Cross, please do not drop little poopies on our heads. That is not being kind. All right, boys and girls, I think you get what kindness is and what it means to do to others as you would have them do to you.
Yes, whatever I want someone to do to me, I should make sure I do to them. So I'm going to be kind to others so that they will be kind to me.
That's right. Let's say our Bible verse one more time, Chris Cross.
Okay.
Luke 6:31.
Luke 6:31.
Do to others.
Do to others.
As you would have them do to you.
As you would have them do to you. Good on you, boys and girls.
Great job, Chris Cross. We'll see you later.
Okay, good day, mate.
Hey, boys and girls, it's Pastor Matt, and I am so excited to be here to talk to you about an amazing event we have coming up this Saturday, April 11th, called Eggsapalooza to Go. Now, I know we can't have our egg hunt like we always do here at the church, but what we can do is deliver to you some eggs and candy so that you can have your own hunt there at home. We even have golden eggs hidden inside of some of the bags. So here's what's gonna happen. This Saturday, you're gonna come between 10 and 1 with your parents in their vehicles, pull up to the church, and we're gonna load eggs into your car. Now remember, you can also decorate your cars. We wanna see the best decorated car in the theme of Easter, and we will reward a prize on Saturday to the best car. Now parents, this is exactly what will happen. As you're coming down Pleasant Run Road, you're gonna turn in at the light. Once you turn at the light, you're gonna follow the path that we have marked for you. Right around, you're gonna come in front of the Children's Center, pull up to the Worship Center awning into one of our four lanes. Once you pull up to our lanes, we're gonna ask you to roll down your window. We're gonna find out how many kids you have and ask you to pop your trunk. Once you do that, we'll place the kits in the trunk of your car. You'll head on out. It's that simple. We cannot wait to see you guys at Eggsapalooza to Go this Saturday.
The miracle of mercy. The Good Samaritan. This is Jesus.
Hey.
Who is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. You see, when Jesus was on earth, he wanted everyone to know what God thought about things. So he took every opportunity to teach people about God's heart. One day, a religious expert stood up to test Jesus by asking him this question, "Teacher, what should I do to inherit eternal life?" What does the law say? The man answered, "You must love the Lord your God with all your heart, all your soul, all your strength, and all your mind, and love your neighbor as yourself." Right.
All right.
Do this and you will live.
Wait.
The man then asked, "And who is my neighbor?" Jesus replied with a story. A Jewish man was traveling from Jerusalem down to Jericho, and he was attacked by bandits. They stripped him of his clothes, beat him up, and left him half dead beside the road. By chance, a priest came along. But when he saw the man lying there,
ugh, yuck.
He crossed to the other side of the road and passed him by.
La 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 la, la 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 la, la 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 la, whoa!
Another man who worked in the temple who was called a Levite walked over and looked at him lying there.
He's out.
Huh?
But he also passed by on the other side. Then a Samaritan came along. Samaritans were hated by Jews. They were seen as lesser people, and Jews would not interact with them. But when the Samaritan saw the man, he felt compassion for him. Going over to him, the Samaritan soothed his wounds with olive oil and wine and bandaged them. Then he put the man on his donkey and took him to an inn, where he took care of him.
One room, please.
The next day, he handed the innkeeper 2 silver coins, telling him, "Take care of this man. If his bill runs higher than this, I'll pay you the next time I'm here." Now, which of these 3 would you say was a neighbor to the man who was attacked by bandits? The man replied, "The one who showed him mercy." Then Jesus said, "Yes. Now go and do the same."
Hello, boys and girls. Bada boomskis, bada beamskis. Say that with me. Bada boomskis, bada beamskis. Very nice to have you here. I am Professor Germex, and today we are talking about kindness. Boys and girls, are you being kind at home? I hope so. Do not be mean to your brother or sister, mommy, daddy, or your dog. That would not be very nice. Okay, first off, I am Professor Germex, so I always start with Germex. Wash your hands very nice with the Germex. Germex, yes. We keep all of the germs away. The bad germs are not good. Very nice. Okay. Now, I have an experiment for you about kindness. Because boys and girls, we want you to do this with us at home. So please get a cup. Any cup will do. Does not have to be clear. I do this so that you can see. Can be any cup or glass. You will need a bowl or something to keep your counter very nice and clean. You will need water. Very easy. You will need a spoon. You will need some vinegar. Now, any type of vinegar will do, okay? And you will need some baking soda. Ask mom or your dad or your grandma for baking soda, okay? Very simple trick, okay? We're gonna put the cup inside of the container. Now, first, we will take the water, okay? Very nice. We will pour the water in. Doo-dee-doo-dee-doo-dee-doo-dee-doo. Very good. Fill up your cup with water, okay? Now, we will take the vinegar. Now, what I want you to do is take the vinegar and smell the vinegar. Woo! 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 Bada beamskis, bada boomskis. This is smelly. Oh, it does not smell nice. Smell the vinegar. Woo, very yucky. We will pour some of the vinegar into the cup. Here we go. Pour some vinegar into the cup. Very nice. Okay. Now, set the vinegar to the side, take spoon, stirry. Nice. Now, boys and girls, this cup of vinegar. Woo! Woo! Ah! Very yucky. This will represent our lives. When we are mean to people and we do not have kindness inside, People do not want to be around you, boys and girls, if you're not, if you don't smell good, if you're saying mean things to other people or you're being a bully. Nobody likes a bully. So do not be a bully. What you need, boys and girls, is you need the Holy Spirit to give you kindness, because the fruit of the Spirit is kindness. And we are learning to do unto others as you would have them do unto you. So we already know we have Jesus in our hearts and he is going to help us. So what you need to do is pray and ask the Holy Spirit for kindness in your life. This baking soda will represent kindness. So what we will do is we will take and put in spoon, just like this. Now, remember, this is our life. It is yucky. It does not smell good. Nobody wants to be around somebody who's always mean to them, boys and girls. So what we will do is we will put in the Holy Spirit's kindness in our life and we will see what happens. Here we go, and what, boys and girls? What happens when we have kindness? Now we overflow with kindness to other people. Let's put a little more in. Watch it even have more fun. Oh, look at this. Very good. Stirry, stirry. Nice. So as you can see, our lives are overflowing with the kindness for other people. People want to be around you now, boys and girls, because you have kindness and love for everyone, and you have enough to share. Let's put some more in here. Watch. Here we go. More, more, more. Very good. Oh, here we go. More kindness. More kindness for other people. Ooh, watch this. Put more vinegar. Do-to-do-to-do-to-do. Look at us go, boys and girls. Kindness for everyone, for our neighbors, for our brothers and sisters, for our friends. We have lots of kindness for everyone. So, boys and girls, do not be a bully. Be kind to others. Thank you so much for enjoying our project today. I hope you have fun doing this at home, and we will see you next time. I have something good for you. This is Professor Jermek saying, bada boom skis, bada beam skis. Be kind.
Hey, boys and girls, I just wanted to remind you the importance it is to bring your offering to God. You know, in this time of lack and where we don't may not have everything that we need in our house, and we may not have all the groceries that we want or all our favorite snacks, I want you to remind you of the widow's mite, the story in the Bible where there was an old lady who had just barely anything, and she brought it to the Lord cheerfully. She cheerfully gave to him, and the Lord blessed her in return. So I don't know what you have today. Maybe it's just a penny, maybe it's 50 cents, maybe it's a dollar, but I want you to get with your mom and dad and ask them if they can help you give your offering today. You can either give online at trinitychurch.org or you can give through the text message below. Thank you, boys and girls.
Okay, boys and girls, we're learning about kindness and the story of the Good Samaritan. And there are three things we can learn from this story. The first thing we learn is Jesus wants us to be kind. And in the story of the Good Samaritan, we saw a few people walk by, the hurting man who needed some help. But these first couple of people didn't even show kindness. And that's how we should not be. We need to show kindness. And the second thing we learn is Jesus wants us to pay attention to hurting people. And just like the story of the Good Samaritan, there was one man who was walking by and he saw the hurting man laying on the side of the road and he paid attention. He stopped to help him the best way that he could, and he took care of the hurting man. And the third thing we learn from the story of the Good Samaritan is our kindness changes lives. Just as the Good Samaritan was walking by and he saw the hurting man, that Good Samaritan helped him, picked him up, took him to a place and helped him get restored. He helped him with this kindness and he changed that man's lives. So boys and girls, we encourage you, show kindness, change people's lives.
All right, today's online experience has been incredible. We learned all about kindness. And I want to challenge you to live that out, and actually I want you to pray with me. So if everybody could bow your heads and close your eyes and repeat after me. Say, God, thank you for today and every day. Lord, we understand that you call us to love on other people, to be kind to other people. And even right now, even though it can be difficult, God, we pray that we can still show the best to our abilities, kindness to everyone around us. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, thank you for joining us tonight on our online experience, and we'll see you Sunday.
One way, Jesus, you're the only one that I could live for.
Hey boys and girls, it's Pastor Matt, and I am so excited to be here to talk to you about an amazing event we have coming up this Saturday, April 11th, called Eggsapalooza to Go. Now I know we can't have our egg hunt like we always do here at the church, but what we can do is deliver to you some eggs and candy so that you can have your own hunt there at home. We even have golden eggs hidden inside of some of the bags. So here's what's gonna happen. This Saturday, you're gonna come between 10 and 1 with your parents in their vehicles, pull up to the church, and we're gonna load eggs into your car. Now remember, you can also decorate your cars. We wanna see the best decorated car in the theme of Easter, and we will reward a prize on Saturday to the best car. Now parents, this is exactly what will happen. As you're coming down Pleasant Run Road, you're gonna turn in at the light. Once you turn at the light, you're gonna follow the path that we have marked for you. Right around, you're gonna come in front of the Children's Center, pull up to the Worship Center awning into one of our four lanes. Once you pull up to our lanes, we're gonna ask you to roll down your window. We're gonna find out how many kids you have and ask you to pop your trunk. Once you do that, we'll place the kits in the trunk of your car. You'll head on out. It's that simple. We cannot wait to see you guys at Eggsapalooza to Go this Saturday.